On this International Holocaust Remembrance Day, Secretary of State Rex Tillerson was in Warsaw, Poland. He laid a wreath at a memorial to the Jews who died in the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising in 1943. In Italy, a Holocaust savior was reunited with descendants of Jews that he helped hide from the Nazis. Seth Doane has the story.
He often thinks of that period more than 70 years ago, but today Tony Dorso took a physical journey back.
It was up here in these mountains where your dad, your family helped hide Jewish families?
Yes, it was.
How difficult was it to find hiding spots?
Very difficult to be.
Toward the end of World War II, as Nazis occupied Italy, tens of thousands of Jews went into hiding. About a dozen were aided by the Dorsos.
You were hiding Jewish families in something similar to this?
Similar or worse.
Dorso, Tony Dorso, the little boy on the left, was just 5 years old and didn't understand the risks his father, Giuseppe, was taking.
He didn't do out of ideology. He was illiterate. He must have gone a year and a half to school. He thought because he thought, basically, a human being in distress needs help.
Tony Dorso later immigrated to America and went on to be elected to the New York State Legislature. He always wanted his dad to be recognized for what he did, but didn't have any proof until about 6 months ago, when a Jewish friend tracked down some diaries that mentioned what the Dorsos had done. At a Naples synagogue Friday, he met with descendants of those they helped save. Mirella Sinigaglia's grandfather wrote one of the diaries. For years, I didn't have the strength to read it, she explained. Through the diary, I relived the terror of being singled out for being Jewish, moving from one place to the next. Her cousin, Esther Sinigaglia, simply said thank you. The dozen or so people the Dorsos saved had kids and grandkids, a story of survival amid so much loss.
When a lot of people in the world were doing a very bad thing, and some people that could not, you know, protect themselves, they needed help. And my family and some other people were there to help.
They were poor and up in these mountains couldn't provide much, but what they could offer, their courage and compassion, saved lives. Seth Doane, CBS News, Formia, Italy.